Hello everyone, my name is Kaustubh Pandit. Along with my teammates, we will be presenting before you thermal analysis of FSIV brake disc. My teammates are Siddheshwar Malie, Akshay Shelar and Pranay Dumawat.
Welcome everyone, I am Akshay Maruti Shelar. Along with my teammates, would like to present you our project presentation on thermal analysis of FSIV brake disc. So as we know, in today's emerging and advanced automotive market, demand for efficient braking system is increasing competitively. As the automotive brake works on principle of friction and heat dissipation, the thermal behavior of disc is an important parameter in order to improve the brake efficiency. Overheat generation during braking process leads to fault have large effect on braking performance. It causes brake fading, brake squealing and crack formation on the disc. So we did some research work paper number 1 thermal analysis of disc brake using ANSYS. Conclusion is the study offers a beneficial D-signal device and enhance the brake performance of the disc brake machine. The values acquired from the ANSYS are less than their allowable values. Hence, the brake disc layout is safe based totally on the power and pressure standards. Paper number 2. Thermal analysis of disc brake using ANSYS. Conclusion. From study of various design pattern for different materials, we have observed that the maximum temperature rise of gray cast iron disc is much smaller with compared to the stainless steel, and therefore on the basis of thermal investigation, gray cast iron is the best desirable substantial for manufacturing disc brake. Paper number 3. Thermal analysis of disc brake and its efficiency. The conclusion is mild steel disc brake suffers a drawback of getting corroded when it comes in contact with moisture, and hence it cannot be used in two-wheeler, and thus we prefer cast iron. Paper number 4. Thermal analysis of disc brake on ANSYS. The conclusion is the heat flux dissipation is good for the aluminium, but as the strength of aluminium is poor, we cannot use it for the manufacturing purpose. Profiles made up of cast iron also have better heat dissipation rate, but the tendency of the gray cast iron is that it gets corroded when it comes in contact with water or moisture. Paper number 3. Structural and thermal analysis of brake disc. The conclusion is the present study can provide a useful design tool and improve that brake performance of disc brake system. The values obtained from the analysis are less than their allowable values. Hence, the brake disc design is safe based on the strength and rigidity criteria. Paper number 6. Design of the University of Akron's 2015 FSIV electric vehicle braking system. Conclusion is after verification of this finding using the conservation of energy, it was concluded that the maximum rotor temperature of the front rotors would experience during an emergency stop would be approximately 52.8 degrees Celsius. Paper number 7. Thermal analysis of solid brake disc. The conclusion is the numerical simulation shows the radial ventilation plays a very significant role in cooking of disc in braking phase. The obtained results are very useful for the study of the thermomechanical behavior of the disc brake. Paper number 8. Design and analysis of braking system for ISIE ESVC. Conclusion is thermal calculations for the heat flux are done and film coefficient is determined, which helps in the thermal analysis. The results of coupled steady state thermal and static structural analysis in ANSYS have been shown. In these papers, we found some problems like material used was cast iron, so the disk get corroded and hence had a lesser heat dissipation. Brake disc didn't cool down efficiently, so it leading to wheel locking and brake failure. Brake pad material used were less abrasive, hence faded quickly, giving poor braking efficiency. And the design was basic and no proper ventilation for cooling down, so it is not durable enough for longer testing. So considering these problems, we made our objectives that our material chosen will be grey cast iron or nickel cast iron. But as nickel cast iron is expensive and it is not available easily, so we chose grey cast iron over nickel cast iron because it is cheaper and easily available. And also machining process is easier on grey cast iron. We chose drill design of rotor for better cooling and heat dissipation, and the material for brake pads will be semi-centered asbestos with 30% of metal particles. And designing a better efficient braking system for FSAE EV team.
Hi, I'm Kaustubh Pandit. I'll be elaborating you about the blueprint of our project. Our project is divided into three phases. Phase 1, where the design was decided. Upon the research papers we all studied, we came up with a design of a ventilated disc with holes drilled in it, as it will be more brake efficient and it will have better cooling down efficiency. The second phase, meshing. The design model will be meshed into finite elements for the analysis to be carried out. The third phase, in which the meshed model design will be imported into the ANSYS for steady state thermal analysis. Thus, by this, we can obtain desired results. Thank you.
My name is Siddheshwar and I am going to tell about methodology and advantage and disadvantages of methodology in this project. Step 1. A CAD model was designed on SOLIDWORKS S18. The design of the rotor has 100 holes along with 22 fins sandwiched between two contacting surfaces. Step 2. The design was then imported into ANSYS 19.2 and then carried out about furthering for meshing. In a meshing process, the rotor was created in finite elements for easy simulation for analysis to carry it applied. Step 3. After meshing is done, the mesh design was ready for steady state thermal analysis in ANSYS 19.2, where further it was analysis for thermal conductivity of design disk. Advantages and disadvantages. A grey cast iron is superior to the mild steel. A grey cast iron has better thermal conductivity, less abrasive braking material. It is greater durability over MS, has better anti-vibrational properties. Disadvantage: a poor impact resistance, has less machinability to as compared to steel. It is costlier than mild steel. It is difficult weld due to more carbon content. Thank you.
A warm welcome to everyone. My name is Pranay Kanaya Dumawat. Along with my fellow comrades, I'll be explaining you about our project, that is thermal analysis of FSAE brake disc. So I'll be explaining you about cost estimation. So the material we have used is grey cast iron. Around 2.5 and 4 kg will be the required quantity, and the per kg will cost us around 160, so it will go up to 640 rupees the whole around 4 kg, and the machining as per the job will be 350 to 450 per kg. When it comes to result, in ventilated and non-ventilated, we can see that in ventilated, this disc achieved maximum temperature of 87.69 degrees Celsius. When it comes to non-ventilated, the disc achieved a maximum temperature of 127.76 degrees Celsius. In ventilated, the fins are sandwiched in between the two contacting surfaces. Well, as in non-ventilated, it is a solid disc, therefore no wedges are present. And when we come to future scope, we can see that in future research, the design can be improvised by designing drilled and slotted pattern, which will help in cooling down and also will act as the cleaning medium for brick pads. Superior materials can use as per requirement for the research. Transient thermal analysis can also be done with the help of NCS 19.2 for further research purposes. Hence, we come to conclusion that from this analysis, we were able to study in depth and various factors that affect the braking system. We observed how different design pattern can affect the efficiency. Thus, we conclude that the ventilated drill disc is better for operations in the FSAE platforms. We hope that this study will be helpful for the future terms. And we have gone through the publications are IRJET, that is International Research Journal of Engineering and Technology, volume 08, issue 01, Jan 2021, and second is International Conference of Applied Sciences Engineering and Mathematics, ICASEM. References are thermal analysis of disc brake and its efficiency by Mr. Sumit Satupe and Mr. Akshay Kumar Bote. Thermal analysis of disc brake using ANSYS by Avinash Singh Thakur, assisted by Professor P.S. Dhakad. Thermal analysis of disc brake on ANSYS by Swapnil D. Kulkarni and J.J. Salunke. And on structural and thermal analysis of brake disc is by Viraj Parab, Kunal Naik, and by Professor A.D. Dale. Thank you.